Warm greetings to all the fourth semester botany students. I am Dr. K.Y. Pratibha. In this session, I would like to talk on the development of male gametophyte, or otherwise called as microgametogenesis. Let us understand what is the meaning of microgametogenesis. Micro means small, gameto means gametes, genesis means the production of gametes. Therefore, microgametogenesis is nothing but the formation of the micro or small gametes in the angiosperms is said to be the microgametogenesis. Microgametogenesis refers to the production of male gametes or sperms from the pollen grain. It comprises of events, that is, microgametogenesis comprises of events which lead to the progressive development of the unicellular pollen grain into mature male gametophyte containing the two male gametes or a vegetative cell. So, microgametogenesis is nothing but how the unicellular pollen grain becomes three-celled male gametophyte is called as microgametogenesis. Pollen grain undergo first unequal mitosis, resulting in larger vegetative cell and a smaller generative cell, and is generally released in this binucleate stage, and after pollination it germinates through stigma and style. Now the generative cell undergoes second mitosis to produce two male gametes or sperms. Dear students, microgametogenesis is very simple. The pollen grain first undergo first unequal mitosis to produce two cell stage, vegetative and generative cell, and then generative cell undergo one more mitosis to produce two male gametes. So overall, two male gametes and a vegetative cell is called as male gametophyte. The process where the pollen grain forms the three-celled male gametophyte is called as microgametogenesis. The pollen along with the pollen tube is known as microgametophyte. If you see this picture, it is self-explanatory. As we all know that inside the anther, sporogenous tissue will be there. The pollen mother cell will differentiate and undergo meiosis to form tetrads of the microspores. These microspores separate and become pollen grain. They increase in their volume. Now, pollen grain is the first cell of the male gametophyte. This pollen grain undergoes unequal mitosis to result in the bigger vegetative cell and a smaller generative cell. Later, the generative cell will undergo one more mitosis to produce two non-motile sperms or the male gamete. So, microgametogenesis is nothing but the formation of three-celled male gametophyte from the pollen grain. So, if you see the picture, it is self-explanatory. The pollen grain will increase in its size and it will produce outer exine wall, inner intine wall. In the protoplasm, it undergoes the division, mitotic division, to produce generative and vegetative cell, and later in the pollen tube, the generative will undergo one more mitosis to produce two sperms. So this is the gist of the process of microgametogenesis. Now, before going into the various developmental aspects, first let us study what is there in the male gametophyte. Then we can learn the development of the male gametophyte. The structure of the male gametophyte: microspore or pollen grain is the first cell of the male gametophyte. The first gametophytic structure is the modification of microspore mother cell, which undergo meiosis to produce pollen grain. Pollen grain grows into male gametophyte, which starts inside the anther before pollination takes place. So the pollen grain starts dividing when it is still inside the anther. The pollen grains are usually round in shape with two distinct layers. The outer layer is called exine, the inner layer is called intine. The outer layer, which is thicker, rigid and ornamented, is called as exine. Exine is formed of, it is formed by sporopollenin, highly resistant and non-biodegradable. The inner layer is thin, soft, elastic and is called as intine. It is made up of pectin and cellulose or pectocellulosic in nature. Usually at few places on the outer surface of exine is absent or present in the form of thin layer. So these thin places are called germ pores. The intine comes out through any one of the germ pore during germination of pollen grain in the form of pollen tube. Pollen grain thus consists of two cells, vegetative cell and a generative cell. Once the anther is matured, it bursts and releases the pollen from the anther. If you see this, you will know the structure of the male gametophyte. So it is made up of two wall layers, outer exine and inner intine, and on the exine thin wall, at some of the places the exine will be absent or it may be present in a very thin layer. It is called germ pore, through which the pollen tube or the vegetative cell along with the intine comes out as a pollen tube. So inside the cytoplasm you will find two cells, the smaller generative cell and a bigger vegetative cell. So this is the structure of the male gametophyte. Now let us take up the development of the male gametophyte, that is microgametogenesis. Microgametogenesis takes place only after microsporogenesis. So obviously first the pollen mother cell has to undergo meiosis to form microspores. So meiosis results in haploid pollen grains. So the journey of this haploid pollen grain to produce two male gametes and a vegetative cell is called as microgametogenesis. So microsporogenesis takes place first, where the meiosis takes place in pollen mother cells to form microspores, and secondly these microspores undergo two mitosis to produce two male gametes and a vegetative cell, that is called as microgametogenesis. Microgametogenesis starts once the haploid microspore tetrads are formed. The microspores in tetrad separates and become pollen grains. So remember, the pollen grain represents the beginning of the male gametophytic generation. The newly formed pollen grains are very dense cytoplasm and centrally placed distinct nucleus. Soon after its release from tetrad, it undergoes rapid increase in volume by absorbing the tapetal fluid. The nucleus of the pollen may remain in resting period or for varying number of days, that is from few days to several weeks depending upon the species. So now we are talking about the development of the male gametophyte. So once the microspores are released, we call them pollen grains. Each pollen grain will be very small in the beginning and it becomes very big after absorbing the tapetal fluid. And the nucleus is very distinct, and the pollen grain may remain in dormant state in few of the woody species, but in majority of the cases the pollen grain, once it is released from the tetrad, it as soon as possible it enters the mitotic division. The pollen grains have reserve food materials in the form of carbohydrates, proteins or lipids. Now the vacuole appears in the pollen grain and now it is ready to undergo mitosis. Before pollen mitosis, remember that two things will happen in the pollen protoplast. Number one, the nucleus from the center moves to the side of the cell. The second one, the cytoplasm on one side, which is going to become vegetative cell, becomes vacuolated. So two things happen in the pollen grain before it undergoes mitosis. So first thing, the nucleus moves to one side. The second thing, it becomes highly vacuolated. Most of the cytoplasmic organelles like plastids, mitochondria, lipid bodies are displaced towards vegetative cell. The spindle of the pollen is short and asymmetric. Blunt end of the spindle becomes generative cell. The acute end of the spindle becomes the vegetative cell. So now the first mitosis is going to happen in the pollen grain. So two things happen. I told you, the nucleus is pushed towards the corner and vacuoles are formed and all the cell organelles are towards the side which becomes the future vegetative cell. And here in the when the division karyokinesis is taking place in the pollen grain, the spindle fibers are formed which are asymmetrical. So it will have the orientation of spindle fiber towards the generative side is the blunt end side, and towards the vegetative cell it is acute end. Because of asymmetrical spindle fibers, the pollen grain will produce two unequal cells, the larger vegetative cell and a smaller generative cell. The first mitotic division of the pollen grain results in two unequal cells. The larger one is vegetative cell, the smaller one is generative cell. At the end of mitosis, now karyokinesis is over, cytokinesis cell plate is formed in a curving fashion to give rise to smaller hemispherical generative cell and a larger vegetative cell. The generative cell soon forms a callous wall and grow inward and pinches off from the entire wall of the pollen grain. The generative cell moves into the center of the vegetative cell. The callous wall later disappears. The generative cell of the pollen grain comes to life freely in the cytoplasm of the vegetative cell. At the same time, when these changes are going inside the pollen will also synthesize the exine and intine wall. When the generative and vegetative cells are being formed simultaneously, the wall layer of the pollen, that is exine and intine, are being formed. So now the nucleus of the vegetative cell becomes highly convoluted. The vegetative cell will form pollen tube and carries the generative cell or two male gametes inside the style and into the embryo sac till the male gametes are discharged. The generative cell will be spherical but undergoes change in the shape so as to move freely in the pollen tube. Generative cell develops more slowly than the vegetative because of the smaller amount of the cytoplasm associated in the generative cell. The generative cell undergoes another mitotic division to form two male gametes either in the pollen grain or in the pollen tube. So students, you just look into this picture. It is self-explanatory. You will understand better rather than theory. So when the pollen grain is freed from the tetrad, it is called as the first male gametophytic stage. So it will be smaller in size. It increases in its volume by absorbing the tapetal fluids. Later, the nucleus is pushed towards one side, and on the other side, you find the formation of vacuoles. Now, the unequal mitosis is happening. So, the wherever there is acute spindle fiber, there the generative cell is formed, and the callous, the cell wall, the cell plate is laid down. Because of the cell plate, the larger vegetative cell is formed and a smaller generative cell is formed. Now the generative cell is still attached to the intine of the pollen grain. So in this diagram, the generative cell starts forming its own callous wall. Because of the callous wall, it starts moving towards the center of the vegetative cell. In the meantime, the vegetative nucleus is changing its shape. So when you see the pollen grain at two cell stage, you will find at the when the pollen grain is completely formed at two cell stage, the nucleus of the vegetative cell is highly convoluted and the generative cell changes its shape to the spindle type. Okay, let us go to the further steps in the development of the male gametophyte. Development of pollen grain takes place before the dehiscence of the anther. Pollen grains display germination, that is initiated in the pollen sac, which is referred to as in situ development. So before they are dispersed, only the pollen grain starts dividing. That is why it is called in situ development. Male gametophyte development can be classified into two stages: pre-pollination development and post-pollination development. So let us understand the difference between pre-pollination development and post-pollination. As the name itself is indicating, the pollen grain, unicellular pollen grain inside the anther will give rise to two cell. This is called two-celled pollen grain. This is called pre-pollination development. In post-pollination development, the two-celled pollen grain is pollinated onto the stigmatic surface, where its generative cell undergoes one more mitotic division to form two male gametes and one vegetative cell, that is called as post-pollination development. The development of pollen grain into two-celled vegetative and generative cell is called as two-celled stage within the anther, and it is called pre-pollination development. Now, pollen grain is said to be in bicelled or binucleate stage. The stage is called partially developed male gametophyte. The next mitotic division of the generative cell may start inside the pollen grain or in the pollen tube after the pollen has germinated. In majority of the angiosperm, remember that pollen is released at two-cell stage, that is having vegetative cell and generative cell. But in few angiosperm, the pollen grain can be shed at three-cell stage, that is generative cell undergoing one more mitosis to produce the two male gametes. So let us take up the post-pollination development. In majority of the angiosperms, as I told, further development of the pollen grain takes place on the stigma of the carpel after pollination. Pollens absorb moisture, sugar content of the stigma. Due to this, volume of the internal contents of the cytoplasm increases. It exerts pressure on both the outer layers. Because of the pressure, in time comes out through any of the germ pore in the form of tube-like structure called pollen tube. First of all, vegetative nucleus enters into the pollen tube and assumes a terminal tip position. So post-pollination development continued. In this, the spindle in the pollen tube, spindle-shaped generative cell enters the pollen tube, and inside the pollen tube, the generative cell divides mitotically to form two non-motile male gametes. Now the male gametophyte comes in three cell structure, in which one vegetative cell and two male gametes are formed or present. So if you see this picture, you will understand that only in post-pollination, in majority of the angiosperms, the generative cell divides only in the pollen tube. But in 30% of the angiosperms, within the anther only, the pollen grain can form three-cell stage. So in the post-pollination development, the pollen tube is formed in the stigmatic and style, and then the generative nucleus goes there and divides one more mitotic division to form two non-motile male gametes. So that is the post-pollination change. Now let us take up the differences between the microsporogenesis and microgametogenesis. Microsporogenesis is the formation of pollen grains from the sporogenous tissue through meiosis. Microsporogenesis involves pollen mother cells which undergo meiosis to form microspore tetrads. Microsporogenesis results in single cell pollen grains. The single cell pollen grains will become the first stage of male gametophyte. Let us take up microgametogenesis in contrast. Microgametogenesis is the process of formation of male gametes from the generative cell nucleus that is present inside the pollen grain through mitosis. In microgametogenesis, pollen grain will undergo unequal mitosis to produce vegetative and generative cell. Later, the generative cell undergo mitosis to produce two male gametes. So this will explain the differences between, this picture will explain the differences between the microsporogenesis and the microgametogenesis. In microsporogenesis, pollen grains are formed from the pollen mother cell through meiosis. In microgametogenesis, male gametes and vegetative cell is formed inside the pollen grain, and the male gametes and the vegetative cell will form the pollen tube. Eventually, these two male gametes will reach the female gametophyte or embryo sac, where these two male gametes are released. One of the male gamete will fuse with the egg to form zygote. Another male gamete will fuse with the secondary nuclei to form the triple fusion, which will form the endosperm nuclei. So let us summarize what we have studied in this session. In flowering plants, pollen grain or microspore considered as the first cell of male gametophyte. The pollen grain divides mitotically to form two unequal cells, larger vegetative and smaller generative cell. The vegetative cell is larger, has abundant reserve food and a larger irregularly shaped nucleus. The generative cell is small, spindle shaped. It floats in the cytoplasm of vegetative cell. It is a cell within the cell. Generative cell divides to form two male gametes, thus making the pollen three-celled. Pollen grains are normally spherical in shape. Each pollen grain has a prominent two-layered wall. The outer layer is called exyme. The inner layer is called as intyme. Thank you, students.